Hi, in this video, I will be solving a problem that came up in the homework and a lot of people were asking about. And it is this problem right here of the one element decaying into a second, the second decaying into a third. Right? There are two radioactive elements. This is from section 3.2. Homework number 11 online, it may be some other different number in the book. All right, there are two radioactive elements, elements A and B. A decays into B with decay constant of 4 per year. B decays into C, decay constant of 3 per year. At the beginning, you have 4 kilograms of A, and it slowly decays into B. As soon as B appears, it simultaneously decays into C, and C is a nonradioactive isotope, so it doesn't decay anywhere. Okay? And they explain to you what the decay constant is. The decay constant is a constant of proportionality, so it's going to be the letter K in a proportion. The rate of loss is proportional to the mass by that K constant. Okay, so I'm going to define my variables, A of T, B of T, and C of T will be the mass of A, B, and C respectively. So I like to think of this in terms of compartmental analysis is equivalent to having three containers where the brine would just flow out of one container to another and it flows into another. So from A, it flows into B, and from B, it flows into C. A has no input. Okay, it starts out 4 kilograms, but it's not getting any extra so it has zero input and it does lose some to output. B has some input minus some output and C has an input only minus no output. All right, so the rate of change of A doesn't have any input, so I'm going to erase it. So the rate of change of A, dA dt, is going to be output only. It's going to be minus kA times the mass A. Okay, that's what they say. That's what they say about the constant of proportionality. The rate of loss is proportional to the mass of the element. So the dA dt is proportional to A, and because it's a loss minus the output, so I go minus K of A. Well, where does this output go? It goes into B, right? This output of A becomes the input of B. So dB dt is equal to positive KA times A minus, and then the output is KB times B. And this output goes where? It goes into C. So the output of B becomes the input of C. dC dt is equal to KB times B. All right, so those are my equation. They look kind of scary, but if I solve them from top to bottom, yeah, they look kind of scary because this equation is the rate of change of C is as a function of B. And it's like, how am I supposed to solve that? But nope. By the time I get there, if I solve from top to bottom, then by the time I get there is some function of t. So this one, the rate of change of A is in terms of A. I can solve it and I plug it in here. So the letter A in here will be gone. All right, so let's solve one at a time. So let's number these equations. This is equation one, this is equation two, and this is equation three. All right, let's number the equations and solve them one at a time. All right, the screen was jumping a little bit there, sorry. All right, so the first equation, most of you get this equation, dA dt is equal to minus Ka. Ka is 4, so minus 4A, right? It's a separable equation, so I go dA over A is equal to minus 4 dt. And then I integrate both sides, I get ln of A. And I don't need absolute value because we're talking about the mass of something is positive. I'm gonna keep it positive only, so T plus C. Let's call it C1. And so A is, I take exponential both sides, I end up with A is e to the negative 4t times e to the C1, which to me is just another constant, so C1 in front like this. We're given the initial value of A, we're given that A of 0 is equal to 4, so C1 is equal to 4. And I have my A. A is 4e to negative 4t. First answer. All right, now equation two. dB dt is equal to Ka of A minus Kb of B. Ka of A. Ka, let me write that in again. Ka of A minus Kb. Kb is equal to, let me circle it so I don't have to go look for it all the time. Ka is 4 and Kb is 3. Ka of A minus Kb of B. And A, I already have A, is e to negative 4t. So 16e to negative 4t minus 3b. So that's my dB dt. All right, so this is my new equation two. And it's a linear equation. So I can solve it using integrating factor, okay? So I'm gonna move everything to one side, dB dt plus 3b is equal to 16e to negative 4t. Integrating factor. Is e to the 3t. E to the integral of this. Okay, that's the formula. Or if you think in terms of how do I fit this into the scheme of the product rule, then I need this 3 in the exponent so that when I take the derivative of it, I have this 3 here. So yeah, you can either memorize the formula or you can think of it in terms of turning the left-hand side into the product rule. And either way, I'm multiplying both sides by e to the 3t. Then I end up with e to the 3t times dB dt plus 3e to the 3t b is equal to 16e to the negative t. Okay. This one looks like the product rule. It looks like the derivative of e to the 3t times b. So I'm going to take the integral of both sides. End up with e to the 3t times b is equal to, the integral of this is negative 16 e to negative t plus a constant, c2. Divide both sides by e to 3t, end up with, so I divide both sides by e to 3t, end up with b is equal to negative 16 e to negative 4t I like to think of it as multiplying both sides to e to negative 3t. So I have negative 16 e to negative 4t plus c2 e to negative 3t. All right, so this is the function of b as of the function b. Give me a second. This is the mass of b as a function of t. Sorry about that. All right, so this is the mass of B as a function of T. And we're given that at the beginning, the container has nothing but 4 kilograms of A. No Bs, no Cs, so B of zero is equal to zero. B of zero is equal to zero. I plug everything in. I get zero is equal to negative 16 times one plus C2 times one. So C2 is equal to 16. And my final form for B of T is negative 16 e to negative 4t plus 16 e to negative 3t. All right. So I got my A and I got my B. And now I'm scrolling back and looking for my C equation. Here we go. The equation for C is that it's the whatever the output of B, it becomes the input of C. So equation 3, dC dt is equal to KB times B. KB is a 3. So the CDT is equal to 3 times all of this stuff, minus 16 E to negative 4T plus 16 E to negative 3T. Oh, wait, that's just t. So I can just integrate both sides. Derivative of t of c is equal to some function of t. So I'm going to integrate both sides. Get c is equal to 3 times. Negative 16 divided by negative 4 of e to negative 4t. Plus 16 divided by negative 3 e to negative 3t plus some constant c3. Simplify this, I got 12 e to negative 4t, cancel, minus 16 e to negative 3t plus 3 times c3, which I'm just not gonna call it c3. Okay. C of 0. Equals zero. At beginning, I have nothing but A. So zero is equal to 12 minus 16 plus C3. So C3 is equal to, looks like a 4. So C of T is equal to 12 e to negative 4t minus 16 e to negative 3t plus 4. There we go. Okay. The math, I'm sure, is not hard for you. I think what was hard for you is in setting up the equation, especially for B. And the key is that B receives whatever A loses, and it loses to C. So at the beginning, I write my equation 2 this way. I don't even care what KA and KB are. Okay, I'll just plug them in later. I know I don't know what A is, and I don't know what B is. Doesn't matter. Okay, and I think it's hard for some people because they have this gut feeling that, wait, I don't know what A is. How can I put it in the equation for B? Because I end up with one equation and two unknowns. Right, one equation 2 has both A as an unknown and B as an unknown. But the way it works out is that you solve for A before that. Okay, so it's okay to put A into the equation for B. Okay, and by the time you get it, A is known. It's not an unknown anymore. Okay, all right, I hope that's been helpful. And... Bye.